she was poisoned to the core. She asked me if I'd stay, cause she said she wanted more. But I had my objectives, of which she wasn't one. And by the hour on the clock, I had missed the sun. So I ran out of her eyes, and escaping from her room, I found myself in sunshine by the brightness of the moon. But everything was dark upon the field because of night. And my eyes, they were both useless, not seeing any sight. So I thought about anatomy, how he came to be born. I struck my final match right upon the farmer's corn. And when I heard him coming, I started running for my life. I knew I'd made an enemy in the farmer and his wife. I sprinted to the village, breaking both my shoes. And I knew you had a gamble if you ever wanna lose. My souls, they were both talking as we set upon the town. The fire in the distance by now was coming down. But I heard the farmer roar, so I made it to the docks. I saw three men play games where they just pick up and throw rocks. They told me they'd set sail as the hour did begin. And as our boat hit water, I told them of my sin. They said they understood the sizing of my strife. And they said I should keep running from that farmer and his wife. Sand. And though the men were blind, they helped me understand how to look at places unobjectively. And for the first time in my life, I realized how lucky we could be. So we stayed there for 100 years, just eating jellyfish. They'd sting us in our eyes and shine electric on our dish. But then a violent winter morn sent a shaking in our boots. The forest that was behind us started lifting from its roots. So we set our anchor sailing from its place between the sands. Went back to face our fates somewhere on drier lands. But those blind men, they did trick me, and they showed me to the girl. She had aged so terribly it made the sour milk curl. So up in my anger I made a blade upon my knife. I went back to settle scores with a farmer and his wife. Well, I guess that on the island we had a different view of time. Cause when I went back to face the scene of my crime, the farmer, he could not lift a finger up to me. In fact, just like the sailors, well, he couldn't even see. But he told me he'd forgiven me to setting fire to his corn. He said it was the catalyst that had ended all his scorn. He said that winter came much colder than it passed, and that his wife had fallen ill from the hunger I had masked. And that when she finally died, he'd just fed her to the birds. She wouldn't bear his child, and she'd never say nice words. And then he thanked me kindly for saving his whole life. And funnily enough, I became the farmer's wife.